boxing guy that fights like this, you know, the rest of it fight like in this stance. But all come down to this. A couple of things that you should not do. You don't cross your feet often. So if I'm moving to the right, I use my right leg first. If I move to the left leg. And you keep your shoulder and width apart. You don't want to be here. You don't want to be here. You want to keep your shoulders. Even with that, there is exceptions to the rule, 100%. But from here, you're going forward. You don't get a big step. You just step and you bring this shoulder width. That's the distance of your shoulders here. Moving back. Use your back leg to move. Move that way. Move to the right. What you should not do is this. Even if you pivot. Even if you pivot, it's easier for them to grab your leg, go to single, double leg, use the takedowns. Okay? And I'm saying this because, again, this is a breakdown of a very basic concept. It goes from fight stance, but first fight stance for your kid, for example. You teach kids with a tension stance, to square stance, to defense stance, to fight stance. Now, look, my fight stance here, I'm a righty, and I have this left leg forward. But if it was a judo here, a lot of judo guys, they move a lot of like this. We make them a lot of lefties in boxing. The footwork is almost the same. I hope that helped. But that was a good breakdown of the basic of everything. One of the things I do, we got this frame. We got this thing that I call it home. We go up here, switch your side. And keep this strong here. One thing that I do is to try to get in here. If I try to break it, break. If I can't break it at all, I will do this, and I recommend you to go a little more. Get this a little bit deeper in the back. If this hand go deeper here, it's not too difficult. Keep this straight. I move it like in a zigzag. So keep it straight. Don't let it move. Don't let me move here. I do this. Again, shoulder. And I'm in. Not here. I just took this, which is the collarbone. This is one of the reasons of the collarbone. You should be holding and get this thing here. Put your hand on the collarbone so you can feel where I'm going. But if I can't move it, now I'm in. He doesn't want to be here. That's how many things that I can do from here, including takedowns that we're talking about. So I want you to do a little bit more of this. You know? Like a zigzag coming in. But the whole thing about it is to get from here, keep this strong to the back. And I'm getting, and I'm